very satisfying for us, but at the same time, it's not enough for us. You know, we're looking at this weekend as an opportunity to get, the other goal is to win the championship game and go back to the NCAA tournament with the guaranteed bid. You know, everyone's saying that we're going to get an at-large, but that's not the way we want to go. We want to be able to celebrate. That feeling of defeat on Saturday night is not really an option for us, and so we're taking care of business every day this week to make sure that doesn't happen.
We executed very well. We played very, very good defense, especially when it came down to stopping the ball in transition and in the paint. I was really happy with our performance there. I think we looked to see what worked, and you know, against Albany, getting it into the post worked, and it didn't work as well against the zone at BU, and we were able to have our guards hit from the outside and the mid-range and stuff. So I think as long as we are flexible and can read that, then there's not going to be a problem.
Drawing on last year's experience is, you know, all we really need to know that, you know, we went through the second seed on their home floor, and then we went through the first seed having been undefeated. And I think it's just all about, you know, staying in the moment. You know, when we suit up Saturday night, it doesn't matter what happened this year. That's the beauty of the tournament. And that's why I think it's March Madness. You know, you play your regular season, and although that matters a lot, it's, you know, whether we dance a lot matters what we do this weekend. So, you know, we'll just stay in the moment and draw on the past experience that we know that we can go through the best team need be to get to the tournament.
Our four seniors have been phenomenal. They've shown a lot of leadership. They've been there before, so we can kind of lean on them when we need to know, like, what to do, how to act, and they've just been great.
Well, none of us will be satisfied if we don't win the tournament. That's just the nature of it. But we're going to use the fact that we could possibly go no matter what just to keep us a little bit loose, and we're good when we're loose. So you know, I will kind of use that information that there's a good chance we'll go just to keep these kids playing comfortable instead of, you know, trying not to lose.
And I think, you know, the thing you say in sports is it's hard to beat a team three times, and that's also in our back of our heads. And we know that we not necessarily played very well both times we played them this year. We had a lot of missing parts that are there now for us, and our team's playing very well. There's people stepping up that weren't before, and at the same time, we've been there before. We've beaten them in the postseason on their floor, so we're going in there very confidently.
Championship game, the second time we met them, you know, foul trouble. It was our first meeting there. You know, I think that we ended up getting stuck and having trouble making adjustments, adjustments that we made the next weekend being in playoffs, and adjustments that will carry over for the championship game. So I definitely feel better being there three weekends in a row and going in and having met them twice. So I'm not worried about that at all. I think we made the adjustments that we need to.
Obviously, we're a very confident team. We've been playing really well the last few weeks. Again, our seniors have all been there. Juniors and sophomores even, they've all been there. They know what it feels like to win, and it's nice to lean on that going into this weekend with that confidence.
I think that it's going to come down to rebounding for us. We've figured that out every year we play Hartford. You know, it's always the first game. We can say it to a blue in the face, rebounding, guys, rebounding. Until people know when they get in, Hartford's a different breed when it comes to rebounding. Diana Delva's unbelievable on the offensive rebounding end, and, you know, Ruth Ann Doherty, their freshman, is very fantastic. With Erica Beverly out, I'm sure another post is going to step up for them. And so our big thing is rebounding. They're a very good defensive team. We're going to need to lock down, especially on the inside as well as on the perimeter, because they have very strong three-point shooters.
I think it's a great matchup, and I'm really excited about it. I think it's what's best for this league. You know, both Hartford and Vermont have had great seasons all around and have garnered national attention, and so I think it's only fitting in a year where we've had two teams being ranked in the top 25 that they end up advancing and playing in the final against each other. I think both programs have done enough to get an at-large bid in the NCAA tournament, and I think, you know, no matter the outcome, it's a good win for either program to get over another top 50 program.
We're very excited that it's the two of us in the title. We were just as excited that it was BU in the semis. You know, there's something to be said going through the best, and I think Jen's right that the season should end with a 1-2 battle, best finish. Both teams did their homework in the regular season to accumulate a resume to put us in great shape for the tournament, And it's just the best basketball right now for the league. So we're really excited with playing Hartford.